Friends, we are discussing the reactions of aldehydes and ketones, okay? And here in this class we are going to discuss the reactions of aldehydes and ketones with NH2G derivatives. This we can call the reactions of aldehydes and ketones with ammonia and its derivatives. See, in place of G, if we place H, that is hydrogen, it becomes ammonia, and by placing that hydrogen with the different types of substituents, we will get the derivatives of ammonia. Okay, therefore we can say this is the reaction of ammonia and its derivatives with the aldehydes and ketones. See, these ammonia and its derivatives are containing the nitrogen with lone pair of electrons. And this nitrogen, which is having a lone pair of electron, can act as a nucleophile, and it will add to the carbonyl group of both aldehydes and ketones. See, we can write the nucleophiles such as ammonia and its derivatives. Ammonia and its derivatives, for them we can write this one as a general formula, add to the carbonyl group of aldehydes and ketones to form the addition product. Which is having the formula C double bond N G. Okay. See, the nucleophiles such as ammonia and its derivatives, which are having the formula of NH2G, adds to the carbonyl group of aldehydes and ketones to form the addition product, that is carbon, which is forming a double bond with nitrogen and a substituent. For this we can write the general reaction. Here this is a carbonyl group of aldehyde or ketone. See, here if you are writing on both the bonds substituents other than hydrogen, then it becomes ketone. Or if you are writing on one side hydrogen and other side a substituent, that may be alkyl or aryl, then it becomes aldehyde. We can write as aldehyde or a ketone. When an aldehyde or a ketone is treated with ammonia or its derivatives, that is NH2G, in presence of an acidic medium, we will get the addition product along with the liberation of one molecule of an water. Okay, this is the general reaction. And here I am telling the derivatives of ammonia and its derivatives. See, what are the derivatives we will get by replacing this G? See, here G may be either hydrogen or an alkyl group or an aryl group, or it may be OH, or it may be NH2, or it may be C6H5NH, etc. Okay, here number of possibilities are there for the G, that is the group which is attached to this NH2. See, I will write the derivatives of ammonia, or I will write ammonia derivatives, which are having the formula of NH2G, which are having this formula by replacing this G. See, for ammonia, this G is what? Hydrogen. I will write the formula for ammonia, NH2H. This G is hydrogen. Say, for amine, this G may be any alkyl or aryl group. that we can write as NH2R, correct? For amine, for hydroxyl amine, if this G is replaced, or if this G is an OH group, then this becomes a hydroxyl amine. These all are the derivatives of ammonia. For hydrogen, we can write NH2NH2. Here this G is an NH2 group. This is hydrogen. Then for phenyl hydrogen, we can write NH2, then NH C6H5 or a phenyl ring, correct? Then for 2,4 dinitro phenyl hydrogen, 2,4 dinitro phenyl hydrogen. See, here also we have common NH2. For this NH, then phenyl ring is there. And for this phenyl ring, on second position and on fourth position, nitro groups are there. NO2 groups are there. This is 2,4 dinitro phenyl hydrogen. It is also called 2,4-DNP. 2,4-DNP, dinitro phenyl hydrogen. Then seventh, we can write semi-carbazide. Here NH2, NH, C double bond O, NH2. Here this is the G. Here this NH2 is common in all the compounds. The only difference is there, here we are changing the G. Okay, that is the group which is attached to this NH2 group. These all are called what? The derivatives of ammonia. Okay, and these all compounds, when treated with the aldehydes or ketones, are giving the same product. Let me explain about the general reaction mechanism for this reaction of aldehydes and ketones with NH2 derivatives. Then later I will discuss the particular examples by taking all these derivatives of ammonia. Okay, see, the general mechanism. The general mechanism involves what? See, this is the carbonyl group of an aldehyde or a ketone. The carbonyl group of aldehyde and a ketone. And here we are using the acidic medium, or we are using the acid as a catalyst for this reaction. And we know that this oxygen, being more electronegative than this carbon, will drag this pi bonded electron pairs towards itself, and it will use these bonded pairs of electrons to form a bond with the proton, or we can say this one, the step of protonation of the carbonyl group of aldehyde or ketone by the help of a acid catalyst. Okay, here this carbonyl oxygen will get protonated by the proton, which is donated by the acid. Okay, then now this carbon, after the breakage of this bond, it becomes unstable with three bonds, 1, 2, and 3 bonds, and therefore it is looking for the electron donors. And here these ammonia derivatives, NH2G, these ammonia derivatives, which are having a lone pair of electrons on nitrogen, will act as a nucleophile and will attack on the electron deficient carbon to fulfill its valency. Now this carbon will form four bonds, like single bond, OH. This oxygen is forming OH bond, OH. And now here, N, G, H, H. And we know that the valency of nitrogen is only 3. And here it is forming four bonds, means after donating a lone pair of electron and forming four bonds, it becomes unstable and gets a positive charge. And as compared to the nitrogen, as compared to the carbon, this nitrogen is highly electronegative. And being highly electronegative and with positive charge, means it becomes unstable. okay, and to get stability, it will drag these bonded pair of electrons towards itself. One of the bonded pairs of electrons between the nitrogen and hydrogen will move towards the nitrogen, and here this hydrogen will go out as H plus. That is the removal of hydrogen. Deprotonation will take place, and here we will get NGH. This nitrogen is having lone pair of electron and OH. Okay. Then now here a loss of water molecule takes place. See here, this hydroxyl group will go out of the reaction, and along with this hydroxyl group, this nitrogen is also going, and this nitrogen is going without any electrons, and therefore this bond is moving towards this carbon nitrogen single bond. Okay, this hydroxyl group is going out with the bonded pair of electron, and here this carbon becomes unstable with three bonds, and hence it wants to get stability by dragging this bonded pair of electron towards the carbon nitrogen single bond, and this hydrogen will now combine with this OH and forms H2O. Okay, and here we can write a C, single bond, double bond, N, G, and this nitrogen is having a lone pair of electron. This is the addition product. Correct? This is the general reaction mechanism for the reactions of aldehydes and ketones with the NH2G derivatives. NH2G derivatives are, that is the ammonia and its derivatives. Okay. Yes. Now take down some examples for this one. Examples. See here, if these aldehydes and ketones are reacting with, example number one is on reaction of aldehydes and ketones with ammonia. Reactions of aldehydes and ketones with ammonia. That means here the G is hydrogen. See here, what will happen here? Here we are studying the formation of imine. After the reaction, we are getting imine. See, I am writing the particular examples for this one by taking formaldehyde. Formaldehyde, when it is treated with ammonia, that is NH2H, ammonia, in presence of an acid as a catalyst, here we will get CH3, CH double bond. This oxygen and these two hydrogens will go out as water molecules. Here I will write H2O. This oxygen and these two hydrogens will go out as H2O, and this carbon will now bond, forms double bond with the nitrogen and H. Okay, this is called imine, and as it is formed by, sorry, it is an acetaldehyde. Sorry, it is acetaldehyde, and as it is forming by the acetaldehyde reaction with ammonia, its name is acetaldehyde. Okay, here we can take a ketone, that is acetone. When it reacts with ammonia in presence of an acid medium, we will get CH3 double bond NH plus H2O. Okay, it, as it is formed by acetone, the imine is called acetonimine. Okay, this is the reaction of ammonia with the carbonyl groups like aldehydes and ketones. The second one we can study the reactions of, or the reactions of aldehydes and ketones with the hydroxylamine. Hydroxylamine, that is the formation of oxime. See, the aldehydes and ketones on reaction with hydroxylamine will give oximes. Here also I am taking the same example, that is acetaldehyde. When it is treated with hydroxylamine, here the G is OH, hydroxylamine. Okay, please look at this one, hydroxylamine, which is having NH2OH. Here the G is OH. And in presence of an acid as a catalyst, here this oxygen will go out with the hydrogen by forming H2O, CH3CH, and this carbon will form double bond with nitrogen and OH. This is an oxime, and as it is formed by acetaldehyde, we can write this one as acetaldehyde oxime. As it is forming by the acetaldehyde, we can write this one as an acetaldehyde oxime. Okay, like this we can write for ketones also. See, here I am writing only for aliphatic aldehydes and ketones. You can try these reactions for aromatic aldehydes and ketones. Okay, plus an hydroxylamine, that is NH2OH, we will get CH3 double bond NOH. This is acetone, and this one is an oxime of acetone, therefore it is an acetone oxime along with the formation of water molecule. Like this we can write the reaction for aldehydes and ketones with before this one we can write for hydrogen. The reactions of aldehydes and ketones with hydrogen, that is the formation of hydrazone. See, whenever the aldehydes or ketones treated with hydrogens, that is NH2. Here the G is an NH2, hydrogens, acetaldehyde. These will easily react in presence of an acidic medium to form hydrazones, N single bond NH2 plus H2O. Here this H2 and this O will go out as H2O, and this carbon will form double bond with the nitrogen single bond NH2. This is an hydrazone, and as it is formed by acetaldehyde, it is called what? Acetaldehyde hydrazone. Like this we can write for ketone, that is acetone, when it is treated with an hydrazone in an acidic medium, we will get a CH3 double bond NH2 plus H2O. Okay, its name is acetone hydrazone. Then next we can write the reactions of aldehydes and ketones with phenyl hydrazine, that is the formation of phenyl hydrazones. See, the aldehydes and ketones on reaction with phenyl hydrazine in presence of an acidic medium, they will form phenyl hydrazones, the corresponding phenyl hydrazones. See, here also I am taking the same examples. For aldehydes, I am taking acetaldehyde. When it is treated with NH2NH phenyl ring. Correct? This is phenyl hydrazine. In presence of an acidic medium, get CH3CH double bond N, single bond NH. See here, this hydrogens, two hydrogens will go out with the O and forming H2O. and this nitrogen and this group will remain NH. This is what? Acetaldehyde phenyl hydrazone. Acetaldehyde phenyl hydrazone. Okay, like this we can write for ketones, that is acetone NH2NH in presence of an acidic medium CH3 double bond NH. Okay, this is what? Acetone phenyl hydrazone. Like this we can write the reaction of aldehydes and ketones with 2,4 dinitro phenyl hydrogen. 2,4 dinitro phenyl hydrogen. This is also called 2,4 DNP, or we can write this one as the formation of 2,4 dinitro phenyl hydrazone. 2,4 dinitro phenyl hydrazone. Okay, see here also I am taking the same example of aldehyde, that is acetaldehyde. When acetaldehyde is treated with 2,4 DNP, that is NH2NH, NO2 and NO2. This is a 2,4 dinitro phenyl hydrogen. Okay, in presence of an acidic medium, it releases a molecule of water, correct? And here we will get a CH3H double bond N single bond NH. This is NO2. And here we will get acetaldehyde 2,4 dinitro. This is acetaldehyde 2,4 dinitro phenyl hydrazone. Okay, like this we can write for ketones also. CH3. This is acetone. When it is treated with 2,4 DNP, this is 2,4 DNP in presence of an acidic medium, we will get CH3 double bond NH O NO2, sorry, this is NO2 plus H2O. Acetone 2,4 dinitro phenyl hydrazone. Okay, this is the reactions of aldehydes and ketones with 2,4 dinitro phenyl hydrogens. Or we can study, this is which one? Sixth one. The reactions of aldehydes and ketones with semi-carbazide, or we can write this one as the formation of semi-carbazone. Okay, see here also I am taking the same example for aldehydes. Acetaldehyde, when it is treated with semi-carbazide, which is having the formula of NH2NH C double bond O NH2, semi-carbazide see here, semi-carbazide, which is having the NHC double bond O NH2 group in place of G. This is semi-carbazide. Okay. This on reaction with acetaldehyde in acidic medium will form CH3C H double bond N NH C double bond O NH2. This is acetaldehyde semi-carbazone. Acetaldehyde, this is acetaldehyde semi-carbazone, okay, along with the liberation of a molecule of water. Like this we can write for ketones also, double bond O plus NH2 NH C double bond O NH2. See, in presence of an acid catalyst CH3 C CH3 double bond N NH single bond C double bond O NH2 plus H2O. This is acetone and semi carbazone. Correct. This is all about the reaction of aldehydes and ketones with the ammonia and its derivatives. Okay, here this is the general reaction. See, this is the general reaction for aldehydes and ketones with ammonia and its derivatives in presence of an acid catalyst, and after the reaction we are getting the addition product of this type along with the liberation of a molecule of water. Okay, these are all the derivatives of ammonia. Okay, and this is the general mechanism for the reaction of aldehydes and ketones with the ammonia and its derivatives. And whenever you are going the G, means by changing this G with hydrogen R OH NH2 like this, the reaction will not change at all. The reaction is the same whatever the nature of this G is, or the group this G is in the presence of an acid as a catalyst. Okay, and here we have discussed the reactions of acetaldehyde and acetone with the ammonia and its derivatives. And here I am giving the assignment question that write the reactions of C6H5 C double bond O H and C6H5 C double bond O CS3 with ammonia and its derivatives. Write the reactions of benzaldehyde and acetophenone. Benzaldehyde and acetophenone with ammonia and its derivatives. This is the assignment question, and like this only you have to write.